Hello, I like to make today a cake which is great for various occasions. It's great for Mother's Day, for child celebration, for birthday, and especially for Father's Day, because it's great type of chocolate cake. So what we need for this recipe, first of all, we need to preheat our oven to 180 degrees Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit, and we need grease and lard. You can use a cooking spray, or you can use a simple butter, does not really matter, whatever you prefer. Grease two round baking tins, 20 centimeter in diameter, which is 8 inches. So as you can see, we grease and line the bottom of a cake and the sides as well. So once we line two baking tins, we set them aside. Next step is, what we have to do is, we need a large bowl, and we need a combine, basically, 3 eggs, need to be at a room temperature, followed by a self-raising flour, which is, we need 175 gram or 6 1/4 ounces. Next is, we have 175 gram or 6 1/4 ounces of dark muscovado sugar. If you cannot find the type of sugar, what you can do, you can use just brown sugar instead. It will be slightly different taste, but I think it will do trick. So we need 175 gram of dark muscovado sugar. Next step is, we need baking powder, which is 1 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder. Then followed by 175 gram or 6 1/4 ounces of unsalted butter. So we combine these ingredients into a large bowl. And what we do is, next step is to, we need use an electric mixer, and we beat until our mixture become light, fluffy, and fully combined. Once you finish beating, as you can see, it's become lighter and fluffy and very well combined mass. So what we do is, next, we need now 40 gram of cacao powder, which is 1 1/2 ounces, and we need 5 tablespoons of boiling water. So we get boiling water, and we just making a paste. 2, 3, 4, and 5. So what we do is, we carefully mix it together to create like a paste, sort of. Then we will add to our cake. As you can see, it's all quite incorporated. Mix it to create nice, good paste, and add to the cake mixture. Once you add the cacao paste into cake mixture, need to be carefully folded until the chocolate mixture has fully mixed in, fully incorporated. As you can see, it changed color quite a bit. So what we do is next, now we will pour out equal portions of mixture into two tins. So we subdivided mixture into two tins basically. I just scoop it same amount simply. And what we do is next, just spread it. Make sure it's nice and even. And the second one. So after this, what we do is we place in our prepared oven and bake for about 20 to 25 minutes. It just depends from your oven. Check it out with a skewer inserted in the middle of cake to make sure it comes out clean. So once cake baked, leave to cool for a few minutes in the tins, then transfer to wire cooling rack. But for now, please bake for 20 to 25 minutes until it's fully cooked through. Once our sponges are baked, as I said before, leave to cool for a few minutes in the tins, then transfer to wire cooling rack to cool completely. It's a quite nice, very airy, sort of like a fragile type of sponges. So what we do is we place one sponge. As you can see, when they rise, they're actually quite even, sort of. We don't need to trim them or level them or anything at all. They're nice, soft and beautiful. So what we do is today we're using Nutella simply to sandwich them together. So what we do is we just carefully apply, oops, a layer of Nutella, just enough to spread it sort of. And what we do, we will sandwich with a second sponge. It does not have to be perfect. We just need spread enough to make sure we join these two sponges together. So carefully apply Nutella and place second sponge bottom part up. Once you sandwich two sponges with Nutella, to make sure that second sponge, please put bottom part, which is we baked on, up, be upside down, because we wanted this nice and straight. It's also much easier to spread Nutella as well. So what we do is, once we sandwich two sponges, we spread Nutella all around our cake, as well on the sides as well. So we done sides, we done top. Next step is to use our decorations. For decorations today, we will use chocolate fingers. It's like a biscuit sort of type of fingers. And once we're all happy what we have here, we just nicely set it. make sure it's all nice and straight. More straighter it is, more easier to connect the chocolate biscuits. So once we've done all that, what we do is we need about 3 packets of chocolate fingers. It's a simply a type of crisp biscuits covered with milk chocolate. If you don't have this in your country, you can simply get something like a Kitty Kat, just a normal one. This is particular caramel. I just don't have an original one, but just use original Kitty Kat, because it gets, if you break them into segments, they get exactly nice and straight as well. So what we do is now we simply open our chocolate biscuits, and what we do is we start connect them upright all around cake, because Nutella is set a little bit longer, so it makes enough time for us to connect all the chocolate fingers all around cake. So let's continue until we cover whole around our cake. Once you connect all the chocolate biscuits, I take notice also that we actually don't need 3 packets of the chocolate fingers. I use only basically 1.5 packets. So each packet is 200 gram, 7 ounces. So if you get a packet which is 200 gram, you need only probably 2 packets, that's all. But I will write in the description box. So once we've done that, good idea is to find a ribbon of your choice. This sort of ribbon, smaller, bigger, different color, it's up to you. Just tie it around your chocolate biscuits to make sure they stay on place nice and neat. So what we do is next take place the toothpick and just draw subdivide top part into 5 even sequences. So once you've done that, what we do is we just then place five chocolate biscuits to show this subdivision. And next is very simple step, is to simply place in your sections all your favorite sweets, or sweets your father like, or your child. So you subdivide all these 5 different ones into various sweets. It could be a Maltese, for example. They look like M&M's, just a little bit more larger. Or, for example, Maltese. These ones actually are peanut M&M's. Crispy M&M's. Yes, that's right, yeah. And or any type of round sweets, or the white and black chocolate buttons as well. This would be nice. So started simply decorating your cake. Very simple way, just adding it, your sweets into your prepared sections, to surprise your father. It's depend for who you're actually making it. So keep going like this until you fill up all with different sweets. Once you finish, decorate your cake with sweets of your choice. If you like, use some chocolate sprinkles and with spoon, just to place in the middle. Just to make it more finished, more attractive look. And here we are with chocolate cake with a beautiful, really fluffy sponges. You can, of course, choose sweets of your choice and just simply subdivide it with 5 chocolate fingers and place them around. I hope you do like this interesting recipe. And thank you very much for your time with me today. Please do try. Thank you. Until next time. Goodbye. Everything will be in the description box. The ingredients and method. Thank you. Bye-bye.